Hi everyone, it's Sam from Sitemate. Pre-starts are used to brief teams before they start work about the planned works for that day or that shift. So in this video, we're going to look at how easy it is to record pre-starts inside of Dashpivot, which is faster, you know, than passing around multiple bits of paper to a bunch of workers, you know, where things might get lost. So we've already gone ahead and set up a pre-start template. I'm going to go ahead and add a pre-start here. So I'm going to click this green button. You see that we've already set up a whole bunch of fields, so I'm going to go ahead and fill out just a few of these. Plug in today's date, meeting prepared by me, conducted by, let's say it's going to be Sarah. The supervisor might be James. We're in zone one, etc. And we can start to fill out this particular pre-start. So, you know, we can add line items for all of the work activities and fill out this table which has been set up. And then, you know, we've got a couple of checks for the different permits that we might have required. We can easily go ahead and select some of those. We can add photos if we need to of the site, or, you know, maybe we did a sketch and we want to add that to this particular form. We can do that here. And you'll see at the bottom, we've got some areas to sign it off. So for everyone inside of your team who has a Dashpivot account, they can simply click this sign on internal signature. And that's just going to stamp their name and the time and date onto this particular form. For the workers who might be attending your site who don't have a Dashpivot account or who aren't part of your organization, they can use this manual signature, which is basically going to prompt them to fill in their details. So, you know, their first and last name, their company, and their signature. And you can do this on the phone as well. Once you're happy with that, you can hit save, and you'll see that we've now got that pre-start now sitting here. And over time, that will look something a little more like this, where, you know, you've got multiple records sitting in here. And one of the great things about Dashpivot is that, you know, you can reorganize all of this information because it's digital. So, you know, we can toggle across to a register view, and suddenly we've got all of that information now stored in a register, similar to something like Excel. So we've got, you know, columns which are basically mapped to all of those fields which we've set up inside of our template. And it means that, you know, it's really easy to filter for things. So if we wanted to look at the pre-starts for, you know, the current month or the past 30 days, something like that, we can apply that inside of here and find the information and go back and find that information relatively quickly. We can also export it if we need to. We can select these and the options sit up here. So maybe we need to download it. We can do that there. And we can also send it to somebody. So if for whatever reason, you know, you need to push it to someone else, you can click this send PDF button up the top here. It'll prompt you to enter in an email address, and that person will receive a notification with this PDF version attached. So that summarizes how, you know, daily pre-starts can be set up inside of Dashpivot. If you want to get started, we actually have a pre-start template available for free from inside of the template library which we've got set up. So you can click this add new template button inside of the template section. Click on this choose from free public template library button, and then you can search for pre-start. And you'll be able to get started with that straight out of the box, and you can make some adjustments as required for your organization. And that's really how you can easily record and organize your pre-starts in Dashpivot.